Research shows this can boost productivity and reduce stress in the office. No, we're not talking about free donuts. We're talking about plants. Teresa Strasser looks at plants that can survive and help you thrive on The Breakdown.
It seems plants aren't just good for the environment, but can benefit you at work.
I know I need my cup of pens, my stapler. Why do I need a plant?
Helps reduce your stress, boost productivity and creativity.
Right in the garden owner, Anne Lloyd Wright Levi, yep, she's the great-granddaughter of famous architect Frank Lloyd Wright, is helping this plant murderer find potted pals that work in an office environment.
Generally, what sort of plant is going to survive on my desk?
I'm going to start you out with something that's just going to be low maintenance.
Okay, good.
Low water. So you've got your pothos, your succulents. Cactus are very low water.
Low water plants are easy on your schedule and are forgiving when you take a day off. Just beware of overwatering.
True story, I have killed a cactus.
Because you probably overwatered
it. That's what I did.
They can go a long time, a month without water.
Cactus and succulents are a good option for easy care, but if you're lacking in the natural light department, go with low light plants.
Sadly, a lot of us work in environments with very little natural light, so what's a good plant for our desk?
If you have that low light, go with the spider plant, Dracaena, Pothos philodendron, or last but not least, your ZZ plant.
How much light do these need to survive?
Low to medium. They'll grow slower in low light, grow faster in a bright light.
And if you're worried about your toxic airspace, a plant might help.
So having a green plant at your desk can obviously boost your spirit, but is it doing anything good for your air?
All plants will purify the air in some way. Sansevierias, or they call them snake plants, are one of the top air purifiers according to NASA.
When you're in a tin can in space, your air supply is pretty important, so NASA has done the studies.
Formaldehyde, benzene, xylene, trichloroethylene, and another little thing that they do is they put oxygen back in the air at night.
I'm already feeling more creative, more productive, and I'm pretty sure the air is just a little less toxic.
Bringing life to your desk is on The Breakdown.